Well, I think the Blue Ocean vision for MUIH is really, you know, what I've spoken about. I think that we want to have a first-rate clinic that truly embodies what integrative health looks like, so that when you walk in the door, you could be seen by multiple providers. You have your acupuncturist for this, your herbalist is giving you that, your nutritionist and so forth. We have rooms where you have case management teams sit together with several providers talking about how to care for you and how to bring together all of those services. One of the new programs that we're going to have, we haven't been fully approved for yet, but the board has approved, is to look at naturopathic medicine. And naturopaths are really primary care personnel. They're the place that you go to find out about how to make all of these connections. So I think we'll continue to develop new programs. I think we'll continue to make the clinic a larger part of what we do and a larger part of our community. But I also think we're going to be working very hard on the research and try to develop those research techniques that tell us when we do acupuncture in this manner, or we give this many treatments per week, we get these kinds of outcomes. We're getting a lot of good research already on nutrition. And I think that as we continue to distinguish ourselves through our research, the partnerships that we have with others will just keep us in the forefront. And then, of course, the advocacy is public policy. We want insurance companies to pay for yoga therapy and nutritional therapy and naturopathic care and all of those other things. There is insurance money often for acupuncture. It's becoming more and more widely recognized. But I think we're in the position now that psychiatry was in 100 years ago and chiropractic was in just a few decades ago, where people are recognizing the value. And as we will help insurance providers, healthcare providers and insurance companies realize that if you treat people in this way, not only are they healthier and happier, but you'll save money, I think that the explosion will begin. So it'll start off as a slow fizzle, but it's gaining momentum. And everything that happens leverages something else. Well, we already give 12,000 treatments a year on average, as well as other sites where we do things off campus. And a lot of that is being turned into research. We also are doing significant research in nutrition. There is a journal that, well, the editor just came and we did a research symposium, gave some talks on that, and has already promised us that an entire issue of that journal will be devoted to our faculty and student research. We're already making some of those differences, but I think that's the opportunity for us to grow and develop, is we don't have all of those pieces in place yet, and we don't have, we still have to move the faculty culture towards seeing that research is just as important as treatment and just as important as teaching. So we still have a lot of work to do to take it to the next level, but the signs are promising. You know, we have 275 employees that live in the state of Maryland. We've been in Howard County for, 40 years, I think. As I said, 12,000 treatments, but those numbers are going to go up. That's going to change significantly. I think that we've always seen ourselves more as a teaching place, and I think that moving forward, we will also see ourselves as a place where we provide care for the community. Those will become co-equal. And as that continues, I would expect those patient visits to double and triple. I see us having an annual research symposium that's national and then ultimately international. And we're supporting Georgetown and some of the other folks that have research symposia in the area. So all of those things are moving in the right direction. A lot of what we can do can be done through mediated communication. And ultimately, for example, a great deal of medical care in this country will soon be provided through telemedicine. And Kaiser already does this. You know, if you want to skip the copay, you can call them up and speak to the physician. And, you know, so those are just extensions of what we can do in a classroom. The idea is we need to prepare our students for the future. So get an electronic health record that really syncs everything up and that also tracks patient outcomes so that we can pull research data out of that. Getting online communities established so that students are not just taking classes, but they feel a kinship with other students who are in their online programs. Our provost and a recent hire, who's one of the associate provosts, are actually leaders in online communication, in distance learning and online coursework. Christina Sachs, our provost, has developed Quality Matters, which is used throughout the state of Pennsylvania as a way of maintaining quality in online programming, and Whit Sally, our associate provost, has a tremendous amount of experience in those spaces. So I think that we will not only be innovating in the healthcare space, but I think we'll be innovating in the distance learning space. Just a quick example, we have cooking classes. I mean, you know, it's not just the ingredients, but it's also how you prepare them and how you use them. And so our cooking instructor will ship boxes of ingredients. So it's kind of like, you know, some of these companies that send you meals at home. Well, she'll ship out the boxes and then have online classes where students are, you know, actually doing the same thing that she's doing, only they're doing at home. So I think that we will attempt to continue to have leadership in the online space.